Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today.
Stevens-Johnson syndrome is named for the physicians who first reported an acute immune-mediated condition that affects the skin and mucous membranes such as the mouth and genitals. Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis are considered to be the same condition, but are along a spectrum where toxic epidermal necrolysis is the more severe form. Both can be fatal if not treated, and the risk of fatality increases with severity. The skin plays an important role in protecting underlying muscles, bones, ligaments, and internal organs by forming a barrier to infectious pathogens and preventing water loss from the body. The outermost layer of the skin is the epidermis, and itself is made of several layers of cells. The deepest layer is called the stratum basale, or the base layer. And the cells here are anchored to a basement membrane, a thin layer of dedicated tissue containing proteins like collagen and laminins, which attach to the epidermis to the underlying skin layer called the dermis. Similar to how the skin lines the outside of the body, mucous membranes, or mucosa, line inner body surfaces like the mouth, tongue, respiratory tract, conjunctiva of the eyes, genitals, and anus. Mucosa is made up of one or more layers of epithelial cells, which, again, are attached to a basement membrane that sits on top of a layer called the lamina propria. Now, most cells in the body have a protein called major histocompatibility complex, or MHC class 1 molecule, on the surface of their membrane. This protein presents peptides from within the cell to immune cells called cytotoxic T cells, also called CD8 plus T cell. If the cell is healthy, the cytotoxic T cell doesn't recognize the peptide as foreign, and nothing happens. But if a cell is infected, say, with a virus, the cytotoxic T cell can recognize the peptides as foreign and trigger an immune response. Once all infected cells have been destroyed, the immune response resolves. Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis are both type 4 hypersensitivity reactions. They're also called T-cell-mediated hypersensitivity reactions because cytotoxic T-cells directly and aggressively attack the epithelial cells in the mucosa and the epidermis and release a payload of perforin and granzymes to kill them. Perforin lyses the target epithelial cell, forming pores which allow granzymes to enter and induce cell death or necrosis. Also, as part of the attack, the cytotoxic T cells release pro-inflammatory cytokines like interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor alpha, which attract other immune cells to the area that cause even more damage. This leads to a loss of the skin barrier protection and erosion of the affected skin and mucosa from cellular death and detachment at the basement membrane. With the skin and mucosa compromised, the body can dehydrate, and pathogens from outside the body can invade and cause an infection, which can lead to another strong immunologic response called sepsis that can cause large-scale tissue and organ injury and dysfunction. Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis are considered variations on the same skin condition. Previously, erythema multiforme had been on the same spectrum as Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis, but now, erythema multiforme is considered its own skin condition. Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis differ from each other by the percent of body surface area that's affected. So, if 10% of the body's surface is affected, it's considered Stevens-Johnson syndrome. If 10 to 30% is affected, it's considered an overlap between Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis. And if above 30% is affected, it's considered toxic epidermal necrolysis. Triggers for the type 4 hypersensitivity reaction in Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis are typically certain kinds of medications whose metabolite peptides are recognized as foreign by the cytotoxic T cells. Examples are some anticonvulsants like carbamazepine, some antibiotics like sulfonamides, some immune modulators like nevirapine and sulfasalazine, and some NSAIDs, like piroxicam. In addition, some types of infections like Mycoplasma pneumoniae or cytomegalovirus can also be a trigger. Two distinguishing symptoms of Steven Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis from other similar conditions are that both mucosal linings and the skin are affected, and these conditions present with a fever because of the cytokines released during the immune response. Early on, there may be flu-like symptoms like a sore throat, cough, red eyes, and a tender, pink skin. Eventually, the rash progresses to having a dark red center, and a variety of lesions appear that might develop from flat macules to fluid-filled vesicles and large bullae. Finally, as necrosis occurs, the affected skin and mucosal lining can begin to detach and slough off, leaving the area looking like it's been severely burned. Slightly rubbing the lesion may also cause the outer layer to fall off, and this is called the Nikolsky sign. A clinical diagnosis is typically made based on symptoms, but a biopsy of the affected area can help make a definitive diagnosis. Treatment typically includes hospitalization, particularly in a burn or intensive care unit for severe cases. Triggering medications should immediately be stopped, and treatment should begin to treat a triggering infection. Systemic immune modulators like antihistamines, intravenous immunoglobulins or IVIG, or corticosteroids may be used to suppress the hypersensitivity response. And supportive therapy with pain medication, hydration, and sterile wound care can help prevent further complications. After healing, there can sometimes be scarring. So, to recap, Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis are acute, potentially fatal, type 4 hypersensitivity reactions where cytotoxic T cells inappropriately attack and kill epithelial cells in the mucosa and skin epidermis. If 10% of the body surface is affected, it's generally considered Stevens-Johnson syndrome. If above 30% is affected, it's considered toxic epidermal necrolysis. The most common trigger is some types of medication, and treatment includes immediately removing the trigger, followed by supportive therapy.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine. Otherwise, you can always support us by donating on Patreon, subscribing to our channel, or following us on social media.